And joins us right now with the latest face-to-face scare for one homeowner.
And that's exactly why police are so concerned, because someone's breaking into these houses while people are home. Important to point out, investigators don't know if all of these cases are connected. Tonight, one woman shares her close call.
I feel extremely violated, and I mean, I've lived here for over 20 years. And this has never happened ever.
Brooke Richards was out mowing the lawn at her Walnut Street house in Manchester. It was 9:45 Sunday morning. She thought it was a little suspicious when she saw a man she didn't recognize walking in the alley near her home.
I mean, we walked eye to eye. I looked right at him.
She describes him as a white man in his early 30s, tall, slender, with a neat haircut.
I came to the side of my house to start to water my flowers, and my door was wide open, screen folded in half.
She thinks the man was only inside a few minutes. He rummaged through purses, stole a couple scratch tickets, and her coin jar where she keeps her vacation fund.
It hurts a lot. It's scary.
Her upstairs tenant was also home and didn't hear a thing.
It's scary. It's horrifying. I mean, you think you're safe at home. It's a nice, easy day. Everyone's out and about in the yard, and then, boom, you got broken into.
The Sunday morning break-in has rattled longtime neighbors on this street and changed a lot for this longtime homeowner here.
I can't even have my windows open now. It does change, so it's sad and it's scary, so, but not gonna get me again, I'll tell you that.
That's because Brooke is adding some security to her home. Now, police say consider installing safety stops on your windows. That actually prevented a home on Laurel Street from being broken into this weekend, the second time that home was targeted. Police welcome any tips that will help stop this crime spree. Live in the newsroom, Jean Mackin, WMUR News 9.
Okay, Gina, Vermont man accused of